गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, वंस अगेन यू आर वेलकम इन सोशल साइंस लेक्चर। टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू विद आवर चैप्टर नंबर 3 ऑफ सिविक्स, व्हाई डू वी नीड अ पार्लियामेंट। सो यस्टरडे वी कम टू नो अबाउट द डेमोक्रेसी एंड इट्स मेन कैरेक्टरिस्टिक फीचर्स। देन वी ऑल्सो केम टू नो दैट इंडिया इज अ डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्री where people choose their own government. The elections are held after every 5 years. Now we will learn about the structure of the parliament in this session. Okay, so you know that all the representatives, whether elected and non-elected, directly elected or indirectly elected by the people, they sits in the parliament. Now parliament has two houses. Okay, so the constitution of India provides for a bicameral system of parliament. So what is this bicameral system? So bicameral means, bi means two, cameral means houses. So there are two houses of the parliament. Okay, bi means two and that means houses, cameral means houses. So there are two houses of the parliament. One is the Council of States, that is Rajya Sabha in Hindi, and the House of the People, that is called Lok Sabha in Hindi. So bicameral parliament we are having, and the two houses are the Council of States and the House of the People, that means Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. Now let's study about Rajya Sabha, that what is Rajya Sabha. So Rajya Sabha consists of 250 members. Of these, 12 are nominated by the president from amongst eminent persons who have practical experience in such matters as literature, science, art, or social service. Okay, so 12 members of Rajya Sabha are nominated by the president. Okay, president will call some of the prominent personalities who are expert in their own field. Okay, the remaining seats are allocated to the various states and UTs roughly in proportion to their पॉपुलेशन. ओके, सो जितनी पॉपुलेशन है स्टेट्स की, यूनियन टेरिटरी की, उसके हिसाब से रेस्ट ऑफ द जो 250 में से बाकी बचती हैं सीट्स, वो एलोकेट कर दी जाती हैं स्टेट्स एंड यूनियन टेरिटरीज को उनके पॉपुलेशन के हिसाब से प्रोपोर्शन में. ओके, ईच स्टेट हैज एट लीस्ट वन मेंबर. The representatives of a state are elected by the elected members of the legislative assembly of that state and by the members of electoral college for a union territory in accordance with the system of proportional representation by means of single transferable vote. So the representatives of states are elected by the legislative assemblies. तो जो legislative assemblies हैं states की, वो elect करती हैं अपनी state में से जितने उनके members जाने हैं. हर state में से कम एक member होना जरूरी है. Now, what about union territory, UTs, the regions which are administered by the directly by the central government. So in UTs, from UTs how the selection is made. So here we follow a system of proportional representation. So here the votes are casted, okay, for the election of such persons which will represent UT in the Rajya Sabha or the Council of States. The voting system here will be single transferable vote means the vote will be transferred. Okay, there will be options that he has chosen first this person, जो भी खड़े हैं कैंडिडेट्स, फर्स्ट पर्सन को चूज करेगा, सेकंड में टिक लगाएगा, थर्ड में टिक लगाएगा. ओके, सो इन दिस दिस इज डन. तो लोकसभा, सो द लोकसभा इज कंपोज्ड ऑफ रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स ऑफ द पीपल इलेक्टेड बाय डायरेक्ट वोटिंग ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ एडल्ट सफरेज. Now, Lok Sabha is the real house which is elected by the people of India. That's why the government is formed in this house only. This house, because the popular government is formed, okay, chosen government is formed and people themselves elect these members. That's why this house is called as the house of the people. Okay, so the maximum strength of the house is to be 552, of which up to 530 members are meant to represent the states, while up to 20 members are meant to represent the union territories. Okay, of these 552 representatives, at least two members must be from the Anglo-Indian community, who are to be nominated by the President of India if, in the opinion of the President, the community is not adequately represented in the house. The representatives of a state are elected in accordance with the first past the post system. So yahan par jo states mein ya UTs mein election hoti hai, wo directly hoti hai. Now only two members in the Lok Sabha are nominated by the president, and that also from the only from the Anglo-Indian community. Okay, here there is a community, there are some people of this community living in India, and two members are appointed from this. So here the system for elections are held, and the person who will get maximum number of votes in his constituency will be elected or selected. Okay, for example, if there are two persons and there are 100 people, 100 votes hain kisi ilake mein aur two persons khade hain, to jo first person sabse zyada jiske zyada maan lo uske 51 votes hain aur dusre ki 49 hai, to 51 wala jeet jayega. Okay, this is called first past the post. Here is an info capsule for you. The constituencies for Lok Sabha and Assembly elections consist of voters of respective areas, but the constituency for the election of President of India consists of the members of Parliament and State Assemblies. जब तो Lok Sabha के लिए या ये Legislative Assemblies के लिए voting होती है, elections होती हैं, तो वो उनके लिए areas इंडिया में क्या होता है कि हमारी कंट्री में एरियाज बना दिए जाते हैं कि इस एरिया में से एक कैंडिडेट इलेक्ट किया जाएगा. ऐसे एरिया को हम बोलते हैं कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी. ओके, सो कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी में डिवाइड किया जाता है कंट्री को ड्यूरिंग द इलेक्शंस फॉर लोकसभा एंड असेंबली, बट ड्यूरिंग द इलेक्शंस ऑफ प्रेजिडेंट देन दिस इज नॉट फॉलोड. देन मेंबर्स ऑफ द पार्लियामेंट एंड स्टेट असेंबलीज, they themselves elect the president. So how the election is done? The country is divided into constituency. Dates are announced for filing the nomination papers. Nomination paper hote hain ki jaise aapne kahin apply karna hai kisi post ke liye, to aap ek page par form fill karte ho. तो ये नॉमिनेशन पेपर्स होते हैं, फॉर्म्स होते हैं जो फिल किए जाते हैं कि मैं इस कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी का के मैं खड़ा होना चाहता हूँ इलेक्शन पर, मैं इलेक्शन लड़ना चाहता हूँ, ओके, देन इलेक्शन कमीशन विल प्रोवाइड यू सम इलेक्शन सिंबल, जो आप फिर आपको टाइम दिया जाएगा कैंपेनिंग के लिए, यू कैन रीच योर वोटर्स, आप वोटर्स के पास जाओगे, बोलोगे उनको, कन्विंस करोगे मुझे वोट देना इस बार, देन यू कैन सी दैट इलेक्शंस आर हेल्ड, एंड इलेक्शंस में अगर आप जितने भी मान लो 10 बंदे खड़े हैं आपके साथ इलेक्शन में, और उन सब में 10 में से सबसे ज़्यादा वोट्स आपको मिले हैं, देन यू विल गेट इलेक्टेड फॉर द लोकसभा और लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबली फॉर विच द इलेक्शन आर बिंग हेल्ड, ओके, अदर्स विल लूज द वोट, अदर विल लूज द इलेक्शन, ओके, इन दिस वे इलेक्शन आर डन, एंड देर आर सेवरल अदर things which are considered during the elections, we will learn about it one by one in this chapter. So we will learn step by step.